Hey everyone, welcome to the Alive and Fearless training series. We are at video number 6. I'm going to do a quick recap of the first 5 videos. In the first video, we understood that happiness is a pursuit. It's not the end results. And we're all being trained to focus on the end results so much that we don't enjoy the journey and we're frustrated and upset. The second video, we understood that what should I pursue? And we took the rotten fruit theory analogy of a tree, and we said there are ripe and rotten results in everybody's life. Whatever results that you have right now in your life is what you should appreciate, learn from, and accept and move forward. So whatever I have, my family, the heartaches, the relationship, the health, the finance, whatever troubles, struggles that you've gone through is part of the learning process. So look at it that way. And then find out something that you truly want in your life. I'm in the US right now, and I'm enjoying my life. I am blessed to be able to create an income and an impact from here. I came here for a marriage, and due to the COVID situation, I'm stuck here and I'm staying here, and I'm able to, you know, kind of live a life that I love and create the results I want. And I want the same for you. And that's the intent of creating this Alive and Fearless training series. So understand what you want. We often are stuck with what we don't want, but we don't decide what we want. If I don't like the relationship, what do you want? If I don't like this health, what do you want? If I don't like the job, what do you want? Career, income. Like, I moved from engineering to becoming a life coach because that's what I wanted from my life. And I had tremendous opportunities otherwise, but I chose to live this life and go through the grind and struggle, and I'm happy I did so. So that's the second video. Decide what do you really want. The third video, we said once you know what you want, what creates results? And we understood that results are created by action or lack of action. So action is very important. That was the bark of the tree. And then we said, what controls my action? When I know I need to do something, then why am I not able to do it? And in the next video, we understood that it is the 4 drivers, which is video number 4. The 4 drivers that control your results, which are what you believe, what you think, the emotions, and the knowledge that you have. If you don't have the knowledge, obviously you're not going to be able to produce the behavior and get the results which you truly want, right? If you don't put the correct actions, you're not going to get the results. Now, the next question is, where did I create this belief, thinking, emotion, and knowledge from? And we understood in the 5th video that it is your 5 people. Everyone is exposed to 5 people. It's, you know, hypothetically 5 people, but you're exposed to your parents, your siblings, your friends, your teachers, your colleagues where you work, and each and every place you get influenced by their belief, thinking, emotion, and knowledge. And you start believing, you start looking at them, you start mimicking them with all the experience and exposure, and then that's how you start behaving. So we call this 5 people influence. And because of this influence, you get limited. Their limitation becomes your limitation, and then you start living that kind of a life. So it's called that your life is an average of the 5 people. And in the 6th video, now we want to go one step further and understand that what happened, what really happened, you know, what happened is when you were exposed to these people in childhood, you were born alive and fearless. We are all born alive and fearless. But then we, because of the influence of these 5 people, we create something called as an artificial you around the alive and fearless you. And this artificial you is not you. It is a personality created because to gel in, to fit in, because what will people say? It'll not look good. I have to please people around me. So you start becoming like people around you. And then you start picking up their limitation, thinking it is yours. And then you create an artificial personality around the alive and fearless personality. Now, what is the test of the artificial personality? Is very simple. Any behavior that you regret, any actions or lack of actions which you know you should be doing but you're not doing and you regret, is a test that your artificial you was in control. The alive and fearless you was not in control. And how do you know that the alive and fearless you is in control? Is when is the time that you did something which you were proud of, you were excited, and it felt like an achievement, and you're like, wow, I did this. That is the alive and fearless you, which you did not regret doing it, right? You did not regret either doing it or not doing it, and you felt good. The feeling was good. That is the alive and fearless you. So you have 2 personalities. One is who that you were born with. The second is the artificial that you created from the influence of your 5 people. So, I mean, you have to take full responsibility. 5 people did the best that they could do. they did gave you the best. I'm not saying that, you know, they had negative intentions. They had the best of intentions, but because what they could do best, they gave you, but they also passed on their limitations. Now, if you have an, if you had an angry parent or a father, obviously you're going to pick up the anger. If you had a parent who was stingy or who came from a background where they believed, their belief system was that money is everything or money is the root of all evil, then you start developing that. The habits that the five people had, you have. Consciously or unconsciously, you know, you didn't have a choice. They didn't ask you. You just picked it up and you adapted it. That's where the, you know, the concept comes that he or she is just like his father or mother or, you know, someone in the family, and they look so alike, they talk so similar because they have been staying in the same family and been exposed to those people for such a long time that they start becoming, looking, behaving, feeling, and even achieving the same. So we say, the, you know, you become the average of the five people that you surround yourself with. So if you want to really grow, and if you want to really, you know, kind of move up the success ladder, or you really want to start being alive and fearless, the first step is to acknowledge that, you know, it's not you, it is the artificial you. There are two personalities that we are all, we have all created just to fit in, just to gel in. And, you know, I don't blame you. You did your best. But in the sixth video, I want you to bring more awareness. In the fifth video, we said, be aware that you have these four drivers. And, you know, in the fourth video, four drivers. And then you are influenced by your five people. And in the sixth video, I want you to kind of distinguish between this is the alive and fearless me and this is the artificial me. And I can clearly understand whatever I am not proud of, whatever behaviors I do and I'm not happy, which does not bring happiness to me, is your artificial. Now, what do I do next? You cannot blame your five people. You cannot tell them that it's because of you I have become like this. So in the next video, I'm going to tell you exactly what to do. How do you break free of this artificial you? And how do you bring out the alive and fearless you further? So if you have any questions regarding the series or this video, post it below the video. I'll be happy to answer them. I hope this series is bringing you value and helping you understand that you can live a life you love. You can get the results you want, and you should. It is your life. You just get one life, and do not kind of, you know, live it, survive it, and then waiting for that to die. I'm blessed over here to be able to talk to you via online internet, through this phone. I'm in the US right now, and I'm shooting this video, doing my best what I can do to help you wherever you are watching this. Thank you so much for trusting me, to following me, and sharing the message that everybody should live an alive and fearless life. Why not? And should get the results they want and live a life they love. If you have any questions in any way I can support you, please post it below the video. Share this series with your family and friends so that they can also kind of break through their artificial you, and they can unleash the alive and fearless you and start getting the results that they truly can get, and the potential, and unleashing their potential that they truly have. Thank you so much. I'll see you soon. Stay alive, stay fearless, dream big, stay strong, and I'll see you soon in the seventh video, where I'll show you how do you break free from the artificial you and unleash the alive and fearless you. Thank you so much. Stay blessed. Bye.